गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। सो इन द लास्ट क्लास वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द फर्स्ट क्लास ऑफ बायोमोलिक्यूल्स दैट इज कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स। ओके, नाउ द सेकंड मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट क्लास ऑफ बायोमोलिक्यूल्स इज प्रोटीन्स। ओके, द मोस्ट दिस इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट क्लास ऑफ बायोमोलिक्यूल्स प्रोटीन्स। नाउ व्हाट आर प्रोटीन्स? सो प्रोटीन्स आर द they are the polymers. Okay, they are biopolymers, or they are also known as condensation polymers. of alpha amino acids having high molecular mass. Okay, so now what are firstly we have to discuss about the alpha amino acids. Okay, so proteins are the condensation polymers of alpha amino acid having high molecular mass. So firstly, they have high molecular mass because of some large number of alpha amino acids, and as I have already written that they are polymers. It means they are made up of a large number of small units, okay, that are known as monomers. So alpha amino acid is the monomer unit. Okay, alpha amino acid is the monomer unit. Okay, so monomers are those which are the repeating units for a polymer. Okay, so by the repetition of this monomer, we can easily get the structure of a complete polymer. Okay, so they are condensation. Now what is this, what is the meaning of this condensation? Condensation means there is some there is elimination of some small species like water, or it may be water, it may be ammonia, or some other species. Okay, in case of proteins, water is eliminated when a large number of amino acids attach with each other. Okay, so the main sources of proteins are milk and some non veggies like fish, meat, etc. Okay, they are the main sources of proteins. Okay, and proteins are very, very much essential for the growth and maintenance of our body. Okay, so next, the proteins which are present in plant sources, okay, like we have cereals and some other food. So they are not so much essential, because all the essential proteins are not, all the essential amino acids are not present in these type of sources. Okay, especially non veggies contain most of the proteins. Okay, so before move on to this polymer, that is protein, we must know about its monomer. Okay, that is alpha amino acid. So before move on to proteins, we have to discuss about this alpha amino acid, why it is known called as alpha, not beta and gamma and delta. Okay, so now these alpha amino acids are the these alpha amino acids are the building block. Okay, these are the building block of a protein. Okay, so alpha amino acids are the building block of a protein. Now what are alpha amino acids? So these alpha amino acids or amino acid contains two groups, that is NH2 and COOH. Okay, these two groups are present in amino acids. Okay, and the general representation of this alpha amino acid is R. This is a general representation. The general representation is R, C, H, NH2 and COOH. Now, why it is called as alpha, not beta? Actually, it depends upon the number of carbon atoms which are present in between NH2 and COH. Or this NH2 is present with respect to COH. Okay, how far it is present? Now, in case of alpha, they are attached to the same carbon atom. This is alpha carbon. But when the structure is like this, okay, when the structure is like this, if they are separated by a carbon, okay, then it is called as beta. Okay, this is alpha carbon, this is beta carbon. If this NH2 is present on beta to this COH, okay, so this name based on the position of this NH2 with respect to COH, okay, if it is present on alpha carbon, then it is called as alpha amino acid, and if it is present on beta, then it is beta amino acid, and if it is present on gamma, and then we have delta also. Okay, so in proteins, alpha amino acids are present. Okay, so this is a general formula. Now there are near about 20 amino acids which are easily synthesized, or whose presence is is known to us. So, out of these 20 amino acids, what is the basic difference? The basic difference is in the R group. Okay, this is the general formula. Na? This is the general formula. Okay, this R group is different in all the 20 amino acids. Okay, we can easily classify the amino acids on the basis of this R group. Okay, so for example, if this R group is H, okay, then the alpha amino acid will be this. The formula is like this, the structure. Okay, this is known as glycine. Okay, this is the smallest alpha amino acid, glycine. Okay, and it is these alpha amino acids are further classified as neutral, acidic, or basic. Okay, now if this R group is CH3, then it is known as alanine. Okay, and if this R group is some other species like iso group is present, this group is present, okay, then it is known as valine. Okay, then it is known as valine. Similarly, we have acidic as well as basic. Now the first classification is on the basis of their nature, okay, whether they are acidic or basic. So alpha amino acids are further divided into three parts, which are again further divided into two subparts. Now the first one is neutral alpha amino acids. Okay, neutral alpha amino acids. Now neutral alpha amino acids are those in which one NH2 group and one COH is present. Okay, in neutral, one NH2 and one COO group is present. Okay, this is a neutral alpha amino acid in which both one NH2 will neutralize this COH to become neutral. Okay, and there are a large number of examples, like we have glycine, okay, alanine, and valine, etc. Okay, so one more thing, for CBSE there is no need to remember all the structures. Okay, but if you are preparing for competitive, especially for NEET, you must know all the structures of you must know the R group which is present in all the 20 amino acids, because question may be asked on the structure directly. Okay, they will give four different options. Okay, and they may ask they may give any name of any amino acid, and you have to predict the structure. Okay, so question may be asked in NEET, especially question may be asked related to this. Okay, so now second one is basic amino acids. Okay, now basic amino acids are those in which two NH2 groups are present, two NH2 and one COH group is present, in which two NH2 group and one COOH group is present. Okay, so this the very important example is lysine. Okay, lysine, L-Y-S-I-N-E, lysine. Lysine is a very good example of this basic. Here we have S, lysine. Okay, and in this basic amino acid, for this the R group is CH2 thrice NH2. Okay, this is the R group. So the structure will be, as we all know, this is the basic general structure, that is R C H N H 2 C O O H. Okay, in case of lysine, this is the R group. So the structure will be CH2. Okay, from here it is attached CH2 thrice, and then we have NH2. So there are two NH2 groups are present. Okay, and one COH group is present. Now, due to the presence of two NH2 group, it is basic in nature. Okay, it is basic in nature. Now, third one is, similarly, we have a very important basic amino acid, that is histidine. Okay, so histidine is also basic alpha amino acids, and one more is arginine. Okay, so one more is arginine. So these three basic amino acids are the most important, because they are also termed as essential amino acids. Okay, now the last one is acidic amino acids, alpha amino acids. Now in acidic, there are two COOH groups are present and one NH2 group is present. Okay, and the most important example is aspartic acid. Okay, ascorbic is vitamin C actually. So aspartic acid, and in this, I think this group is present, CH2 COOH group is present as R group. Okay, similarly we have glutamic acid is also acidic alpha amino acid, and I think in this there are two groups are present, COOH groups. Okay, this is glutamic acid. So you have to remember these two, aspartic acid and glutamic acid. Okay, these two are the R groups which are present in aspartic and glutamic acid respectively. Okay, now these three basic neutral and acidic alpha amino acids are further divided into two parts, that is essential and non-essential. Okay, that is essential and non-essential alpha amino acids. Okay, so out of why they are termed as essential and non-essential. So firstly, what are non-essential amino acids. Okay, so the non-essential amino acids are those which can be easily synthesized by our body. Okay, the alpha amino acids which can be easily synthesized by our body, okay, we can easily synthesize them, and that is why they are non-essential. We don't need them because they are already present in our body, and all the acidic alpha amino acids are non-essentials. Generally, we have three alpha acidic alpha amino acids. Okay, non-essentials. Okay, and out of 20 alpha amino acids, 10 are essential and 10 are non-essential. Now, essential amino acids are those which we are not able to synthesize, and we have to take these essential amino acids with the help of some external agencies, like we have from our daily food. Okay, we will see. We are not able to synthesize these amino acids. Are not already synthesized in the body. In the body, and we have to take them in our daily meals. Okay, in our daily meals we have to take them, and as I have already told you that essential all the essential amino acids. Okay, we also term them as complete protein and incomplete protein. Okay, so what is complete and incomplete? Incomplete proteins we term them as incomplete and complete protein. Now incomplete proteins are those in which all the essential amino acids are not present. Okay, all essential amino acids are not present. Okay, for example, the proteins which we get from plant sources, for example, we have pulses, some cereals. Okay, so these are the example of incomplete proteins. Okay, and in case of if we have complete proteins, so incomplete proteins, all essential amino acids are present. Okay, so all essential alpha amino acids are present. And the most important examples are some non-veggies like meat, and in milk also mostly all the essential amino acids are present. Meat, milk, eggs, okay, etc., fish, etc. Okay, so these are the most important examples of complete proteins. Okay, now essential amino acids which cannot be easily synthesized. So there are 10 essential amino acids. Okay, and all the basic alpha amino acids. Okay, keep in your mind that all the basic amino acids are essential amino acids. Okay, and the three main basic amino acids are lysine, okay, histidine and arginine. Okay, so rest seven are maybe neutral. Okay, the rest seven are neutral. Okay, and in case of non-essential, the three are acidic and rest seven are neutral. Okay, for example, if we talk about glycine is also non-essential. Lysine is also non-essential. Alanine is also valine is essential. Okay, alanine is non-essential. Phenylalanine is essential. Okay, so there are seven others. Okay, now and one more thing, there is no need to remember all them. Okay, it is good if you have if you remember these all. Okay, so now how can we make proteins from amino acids? Okay, so let us discuss that one also. And this is the most important part of proteins synthesis. Okay, now this is all about the classification of alpha amino acids. Okay, now what are the physical properties of alpha amino acids? So this is very important also. Physical properties of alpha amino acids. Okay, so first physical property is they are crystalline in nature. Okay, they are crystalline in nature. They are colorless. They are colorless. They are colorless, odorless. Okay, they are colorless. They are odorless. And the third one is they are polar in nature. They are polar due to the presence of COOH group and NH2 group. They are polar in nature and cannot be soluble in non-polar solvents like benzene, and can be soluble in polar solvents like benzene, etc. Okay, the fourth property is the migration of ions. Okay, this is a very, very important property, that is migration of ions. Now, what is this property? Actually, in case of neutral, or if we talk about the general formula, this is the general formula, HNH2 and COOH. Okay, now these two groups are of opposite nature. This is basic and this is acidic. Okay, so they try to neutralize each other. Okay, in order to do so, this COOH group, as it acts as an acid, it gives its H positive to NH2. Okay, in order to make it neutral. Okay, so and this is known as the this is known as migration of ions. Okay, and what we get, these two are in equilibrium with each other. Okay, and we get a dipolar ion. Okay, dipolar ion. So due to the migration of H positive, due to the migration of proton, there is a dipolar ion generated, which is also known as Zwitter ion. Okay, write it in a notebook. What is Zwitter ion? The due to the migration of H positive from COH group to NH2 group, there is a dipolar ion generated, which is known as Zwitter ion. Zwitter, Zwitter ion. Okay, this is known as Zwitter ion. Okay, so now in case of when we have acidic medium, okay, this migration actually depends upon the pH value. This migration depends upon the pH value. If we have acidic medium, okay, now I am acidic medium mein hamare paas H positive jyada hoga na. Okay, now this is our amino acid NH2 COO negative, and we have H positive. Okay, so this is the Zwitter ion. Okay, now in acidic medium we have H positive. Okay, so in acidic medium H positive react with this Zwitter ion to give, okay, RCH NH3 positive, and H positive is attached to this CO negative group, and it will become a cation. Okay, so in acidic medium they act as cation and migrate towards cathode, because cathode is of negatively charged. Okay, and migrate towards cathode. Okay, and in case of basic medium, if we are adding OH negative, then this OH negative attract this H positive. Okay, and this will be the product. Okay, and this is an anion. So in basic medium, they act as anion and migrate towards the positively charged terminal, that is एनोड, माइग्रेट टुवर्ड्स एनोड, ओके टुवर्ड्स एनोड. नाउ देयर इज अ नेट माइग्रेशन टेक्स प्लेस, ओके देयर इज अ नेट माइग्रेशन टेक्स प्लेस. नाउ दिस माइग्रेशन कैन बी स्टॉप्ड एट अ पर्टिकुलर पीएच वैल्यू, एंड दैट पर्टिकुलर पीएच वैल्यू इज नोन एज आइसोइलेक्ट्रिक पॉइंट. ओके सो आइसोइलेक्ट्रिक पॉइंट इज व्हाट? आइसोइलेक्ट्रिक पॉइंट, एज वी ऑल नो, एट लो पीएच वैल्यू इन एसिडिक मीडियम कैटायन विल बी फॉर्म एंड दे विल माइग्रेट टुवर्ड्स कैथोड, एंड इन हाई पीएच वैल्यू मीन्स इन बेसिक नेचर दे विल माइग्रेट टुवर्ड्स एनोड ड्यू टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एन आयन. बट देर इज ऑल्सो अ पॉइंट, देर इज ऑल्सो अ वैल्यू ऑफ पीएच एट विच दे आर इन इक्विलिब्रियम, ओके there will be no migration takes place, and that that point is known as isoelectric point denoted by pi. okay so this is the point, this is it is defined as that pH value, it is defined as that pH value at which no migration of ions takes place. okay no migration of Ion takes place in place when electric field is passed. electric field is passed. Okay. Now for this electric point is different for the three different types of amino acids. Okay. For normal amino acids, the isoelectric point is normal, or for neutral, okay, for neutral amino acids the pi value is just less than 7, okay, it is near about 6 to 7, okay, write it as 6 to or 5.5 to 7, the pi value ranges from. For acidic amino acids like we have aspartic acid, glutamic acid, so for acidic amino acid the pi value ranges from 2.5 to 5.5, okay 2.5 to 5.5, and for basic amino acids the pi value ranges from 8 to 12, okay, it ranges from pi value ranges from 8 to 12, okay. So keep in your mind this thing, that the pH for basic medium this pi value ranges from 8 to 10, okay, 8 to 11 or 8 to 10, okay. This is there may be some difference, okay, between the pi value, but this is a general idea, okay. So like for lysine the pi value is near about 6.1, okay, for glycine, okay, the pH value is 6.1, that is a neutral acid amino acids, okay. So this is all about the alpha amino acid, the monomer of protein, okay. So I think this much is quite enough. And we will discuss about the protein formation. Firstly, peptides are formed. Okay, what are peptides? And in the next class, we will discuss about the structures of protein also. Okay, firstly, we will discuss about peptides, then polypeptides, and then we have the structures of proteins. Okay, there are three or four different types of structure, primary, secondary, tertiary, and there is also quaternary. Okay, we will discuss about that one also. So, I hope you found this lecture helpful. And thank you so much for watching the lecture.